Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series of Python programming. I am your instructor, Ms. Alpa Rupala. So today we are continuing with our topic Python introduction, in which we are going to learn about data types of Python. So let's get started. Data type of Python. So there are basically built in 5 data types of Python: none type, numeric type, sequences, sets and mappings. So starting with the first one, that is none type. The none type data type is a kind of type which does not have any value or does not contains any value. It does not contain zero even though, it does not contains false even though. If we are comparing the none variable, then it will be only compared by the none itself. So basically, in Java, as we are having the null object, same as we are having the none object in Python. And where we can use this none object can be used as a default value of a function argument. So let us check none. Okay, here is our none. Here x is defined as a null variable. X is equals to none. It will be written as capital N O N E. Okay, if we are checking the value of x, then it will be none. Okay, if we are comparing the x is equals to 0, then it will be false. If we are comparing that x is equals to false, then it will be false again. If we are comparing x equals to none, if we are comparing none by none itself, then it will be true. Only in this case it will be true, otherwise in all the cases it will be false. It does not contains any value. Next data type is numeric type. So there are 3 basic subtype of numeric type. The first one is integer. We can define the variable and we can assign the integer value, as we have seen. Then we can have the float. The float value is a fraction point value, the floating point value. We can define in a scientific form also. Okay, then after complex value. Complex value will be in a combination of like this, like a plus bj, which is a is a real value and b is a imaginary value. So we can define our variable like this also. Then after boolean data type, boolean value can be true or false. So this was all about the numerical. Let us check. Okay, I can assign negative value to my variable a. Okay, so this is the value. I can assign value 16e3, and this will be what my float value in a scientific notation. I can assign the same fundamental with small also. It will have the same output. Okay, now I can assign the value as a imaginary part and a real part or complex number, and this is the complex number value. Then I can assign the true, this is the true. Okay, and I can assign the false also, and this is false. So like this we can have the numerical data type. Now next is sequences. We are having basically 6 type of sequences. In this, the first one is a string. We can basically give the value of a variable as a string, and it will be enclosed into a single quotation or double quotation. And we can also have the multiple line string defined in a Python also. We will check that with the practicals. Next one is bytes. Byte will take the values from 0 to 255. Okay, how we can define the bytes, we will see. Okay, let's check. Okay, this is the variable a. I can define the value of a as a string with using the single quotation, double quotation, 3 times single quotation and 3 times double quotation. This is the first one, double quotation. This is by the second type, that is single quotation. We can use 3 times double quotation, and we can also use three time single quotation. Okay, now for using the multiple line string, we can take three times single quotation and three times double quotation. So this is our value. Okay, Alpa, Rupala in first line, then after it was the enter slash n, then after Rupala. So this is what multiple line using the triple quotation, three times double quotation. Okay, now next data type is bytes. So for checking bytes, let us take one elements array with the positive values only. Okay, we are taking the values as a positive integer values only from 0 to 255. So this is my element array. We can check the value by elements. Okay, now we can convert this value into bytes form using bytes. Now what is this? This is the elements it is. So now our x is converted into the bytes form. Okay, how we can check the value of x, that this is the value of x bytes array. Okay, so for that we can use for I in, as we have seen previously, for I in x print I. So this is the values of x converted into the bytes. Now this is called as typecasting. Whatever type we want to change, okay, we firstly we will write the data type of it, then after into the bracket the variable or object. So this is the value of x bytes data type. Now this particular bytes data type is immutable data type. Now the data type can be of two form, mutable data type and immutable data type. The mutable data type is what we can change or alter the value of it. Okay, but immutable data type is what we cannot change the value after assigning first time. So here we cannot change the value of x. Okay, suppose I am taking the value of x of 1, which is what 1. This is x of 1, which is what 1. If I want to change this value x of 1 by some another value as 2, suppose I'm assigning it, so it will give us error that string object does not support item assignment. Okay, so this is what kind of data type, immutable data type. Same way we can have another type of data type that is known as byte array. Now we are converting our elements into the byte array. So this is our byte array. Okay, now this byte array is mutable kind of data type. How? Let us check that what is the value of x of 0 now. It is 10. Okay, value of x of 0 now. Okay, first of all let us check the elements. So this is the element and this is the x of 0. Okay, then this will be x of 1, this will be x of 2, this will be x of 3. If I want to change now x of 1 and want to assign the value as a 80, suppose, and now my x of 1 will be 80. Okay, to check the value for I in x print I. So this is the value 10, 80, 30 and 40. So this is the difference between bytes and byte array. Bytes are immutable data type, whereas byte array is a mutable data type. And as well as string is also a immutable data type. Next is list, tuples, range. Next sequences are list, tuple and range. So basically we have already seen the array. Okay, now this array was elements of array was kind of same value array, okay, with only positive integer, which we had used to basically store or convert it into the bytes or byte array form. But we can also take this kind of array, which is known as the nonlist, okay, with the square bracket, then separation of the each and every element by comma. Now this element can be of same data type, or this element can be of different data type. If we are taking the all element in a same data type, then it will be represented as array. If we are taking all element with the different data type, then it will be represented as list. Likewise, I can take 10, I can take 20.5, and I can take alpha into a single array. So now this is what my list. 10 is of integer, 20.5 is of float, and alpha is of string. So let us check. This is our list. Okay. Now we can also have same fundamental with the round bracket. Same fundamental with the round bracket. And this is called as tuple. This is our tuple. So first one is what? List. And second one with the round bracket. If we are using square bracket, then it will be list. If we are using round bracket, then it will be represented as tuple. Now what is the difference between list and tuple? So the list is mutable data type, whereas the tuple is immutable data type. That means we can alter the elements of list, but we cannot alter the elements of tuple. So x of 1 is having what value? 20.5. Okay, let us say it was x of 1, which is what? 20.5. If we are changing the value 13.2 suppose, then tupled object does not support item assignment, which is what? Immutable. But suppose we are using the same fundamental, the same list. Okay. Now, same fundamental, if we are changing the value of x of 1, then it will be altered. Okay, so this is the basic difference between list and tuple. Now, next is what? Range. So, this is the range. We can have the range function starting from 0 or starting from any value as we want. Then, second is whatever your end list is, suppose I am taking as 10, and third will be the number of jumps. Okay, this is the one suppose. So it will have the same function. Now this first and second, starting index, end index, and this is the number of skipping point, okay, number of iteration. So this first and third is not compulsory, but the second one is compulsory. So this both are same. Range of 0, 10, 1 and range of 10 both are same. Suppose I want to have value like this, starting from 0 till 10, that means till 9, okay, and 2 step size. Now this step size will define, 0 will be taken, 1 will be skipped, 2 will be taken, 3 will be skipped. And our output will be like this. 0 will be taken, 1 will be skipped, 2 will be taken, 3 will be skipped, 4 will be taken, 5 will be skipped. Because we had selected the step size as 2. Suppose we are changing our start point 10. Okay, if we have written 10 over here, then it will be reaches to 9 only. Whatever the stop size, it will be stop size minus 1. The value will be stop size minus 1. Okay, so this is first taking 1, then 2 is skipping, 3, 4 is skipping, 5, 6 is skipping, 7, 8 is skipping, and 9. So this is the range function. And we can also use range function in a for loop. Next one is sets. Set is an unordered collection of element. That means the element appear in the as we have entered, that is does not fix that it will appear as an output in the same sequence. It can be altered into any sequence, and there it will not accept any duplicates. Likewise, suppose we take the first from the sets, that is set itself. Okay, I am taking set. Okay, I am taking value of set as 30 and 40, 40, 40. Okay, this is my set S with the curly bracket. Now look, I had given the value as 10, 20, 30, 40, 40, 40. But this 3 is repeated, so it will be represented. The frequency will be count will be only 1. And remaining will be set according to it. Like, it is not fixed that we can have all the time same output even though. Okay, it will be altered if I am taking this whole. Suppose I am writing 55, just to show you. Okay, now I am S. Okay, it is not fixed that value will be the in the same order as we have entered. Now the next data type is frozen set. The same set will be represented as a frozen set using the type conversion into the frozen set of S. Now this is our frozen set. Same set is what our frozen set. Mapping. So basically mapping is a kind of group data type in which we are having the key value pair. Now this key value pair is basically is having the base data type that is known as dictionary. Okay. So next one is dictionary. 1 as a key value, semicolon, sorry, comma, then A, then comma, 2, colon, B, curly bracket completed. Now this is what your key pair set. Okay, this is key, it is the value of key, this is the second key, it is the value of key. So this is what my dictionary. We will learn the dictionary in detail in further chapters. Okay, so this is what dictionary. So in next lecture we will learn the operators. Thank you. We will meet in our next lecture.